In Arabic, the name for a marketplace is souk. Each offers great variety. A souk is a place where nearly anything can be bought or sold. But if you think of the Arab and Persian worlds as a spiritual souk, for hundreds of years virtually, only one product has been on offer. But in the last 15 years, something has changed. Churches are now emerging all across the region, in every part of the Middle East and North Africa. In North Africa, Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, and Libya, the Christian population is less than 1%. In some countries, the number of foreign Christian workers has recently shrunk, but ministry continues.
في شمال افريقيا اكثر شيء هو كان يعني في هذه السنين الاخيره انه اكثر شيء انه كنلقاو انه الناس كيجوا بعدد كثير انه اكثر من الاول انه في الاول كان فقط كيف ما كيقولوا انه كان الصيد فقط بالصناره فيعني كيكون بواحد بواحد لكن مؤخرا انه كتحس انه كاين موجود انه كاين صيد اكثر فكاين الناس انه كيجوا اكثر للمسيح انه خصوصا من الاعلام انه
Still, the challenges are real.
في شمال افريقيا انه الناس اللي كيجوا للمسيح انه كاين صعوبات كثير انه ماشي ما كاينش صعوبات اول شيء انه الصعوبات هو كشخص فهو كشخص انه اول شيء هو كيحس انه هو الوحيد انه هو المؤمن في ذاك الدوله يعني هو اول شيء كيفتكر فيه ثاني حاجه انه كيلقى صعوبات انه مع العائله ديالو انه كيف ممكن يخبرهم انه هو مؤمن بالمسيح مع المجتمع ديالو لان النظره اول شيء النظره انه المجتمع هو كينظر ليه انه كانه مجرم
In the Middle East, including the countries of Egypt, Jordan, Iraq, Lebanon, Syria, and Palestine, the percentage of Christians is higher than in North Africa.
Some people, they don't believe that they are Christians in the Middle East. And many of the people believe that Middle East is equivalent to Islam. The reality that there is a good Christian minority in the region. There are Orthodox, Catholics, and Protestants from different old denominations.
You feel that the church is growing, that local churches are growing, that they don't have enough space, that on Sundays there's traffic jams around churches. Most of our local churches are in a growing phase.
But challenges remain.
Challenges related to security, the whole issue of security becoming very complicated and more pressure under pressure. There are challenges related to migrations, and with this kind of pressures, many of the Christians will prefer to migrate to the West. There are, of course, economic challenges, which is pushing. But with all these challenges, we see the growth of the church.
In the Gulf nations, most followers of Christ are migrant workers, often from nearby Arab countries.
Definitely, there has been a great opening and development in the Gulf region. Of course, one of the main reasons can be the economic reasons, which has attracted a big number of foreigners coming and settling in this part of the world, especially in Qatar. And of course, when we say a lot of expatriates, you have a big number of migrant workers coming. And among them, both expatriates and migrant workers, we do have a big number of Christians also coming from different parts of the world.
In Iran, Christians officially number about 200,000 people. But unofficially, their numbers are believed to be much, much higher.
Comparing Iran today to what it was 10 years ago, I would say it's a different world. The impact, especially of satellite TV, has been phenomenal. And we are hearing reports about the phenomenal growth of the church, which none of them really were around. None of these media tools were around 10 years ago, the way we have them now.
But political upheaval in 2009 has led to a fresh crackdown on all Christian activity.
So it's an exciting time in the life of the Iranian church, a time of tremendous growth, a time of tremendous persecution, and a time of tremendous challenge for us to equip and prepare the church as it's growing.
In parts of the region, development and humanitarian aid projects, music concerts, vocational training, large sports events, and other types of Christian witness are taking place, and medical ministries are having a great and lasting impact on entire communities, others are being touched through publishing efforts, especially in places where Christian bookstores can operate. And yet, often the only way to reach and minister into Iran and other difficult-to-reach parts of the Middle East and North Africa is through the use of mass media, including the internet, as well as radio and satellite TV broadcasts, which can even impact both the very young and the illiterate.
Definitely, the impact of satellite television into the homes of people, giving them freedom of choice to see what they want, has definitely given a much more positive view of a Christian message, as people were able to see what Christianity really is for themselves.
But in a region with the fewest number of Christians and arguably the greatest need, additional support in the form of people, finance, and prayer is urgently required to ensure that in the Arab and Persian souk, Christianity will no longer be hidden in a back corner, but instead will be easily visible so that many more will find the free gift that Jesus offers, the bread of life, which is the only product in any marketplace that can ever truly satisfy the deep hunger in someone's soul.